before going into the depth of candlestick pattern, we are just understand the brief about candlestick patterns. The first of all, candlestick pattern invented by the Japanese. So we also called as Japanese candlestick. Used first in 1870s with the opening of Japanese stock market. Candlestick patterns can be used with weekly, daily or intraday charts. You can also use candlestick patterns in minute or an hour charts. Candlestick patterns do not give the price target as it need a close to confirm signals on the basis of candles. Before placing a trade based on candlestick signal, you should consider some other factors. Consider another technical signals along with candlestick patterns. Consider the risk and reward of the trade. Candlestick charts are the best used as a tool, not as a trading system. So after learning the candlestick pattern, if you think that you can trade only on behalf of candlestick, then it is not the appropriate idea. Some of the students ask for me why we need a candlestick pattern. So we discuss in detail how we can use the candlestick patterns. We predict extreme greed and fear phases in the charts and the market timings. So candlestick are the best possible tool to identify greed and fear in the chart formations. As we already discussed candlestick formations, but for the revision, we again understanding the candlestick formation in detail. As your picture shown on your screen is a candlestick pattern formation. You see two candlestick shown in the picture, one is green and another one is red. If the closing price of that candle is close above opening, then it shows a bullish candle, or we call it as green candle. The thin lines above or below the candle real body is considered to be shadow. In the right hand side, that red candle is shown, it shows that close is less than open price. That means it is negative for that time frame. We also called as bearish candlestick. And the thin lines above or below the body, real body, is called as shadows. Now we understand the candlestick formation by a simple example. As you show in the green candlestick, the opening price is $9 and the closing price of that time frame is $13. The highest price for the time frame is $15 and the lowest price will be $7. That means the close is greater than or higher than open. The close is $13 and the open is $9. That means close is greater than open. We consider it to be a bullish candlestick and the color is shown by green. On the other hand, we see an opening price of $13 and the close price of $9, and the low and the high will be $7 and $15. Then close is less than opening. It means close is $9 and open is $13. Then close is less than opening. It means it is a negative pattern. We also called as bearish candlestick pattern. Mind it, bullish or bearish will depend on the opening and closing of the candlestick. Basically, we have three type of candlestick patterns that we discuss in detail. The first pattern is single candlestick pattern. That means by a single candle, we can identify the foremost reversal pattern. Then we discuss two candlestick patterns that decide, two candles will decide whether it is a reversal is possible or not. The third candlestick pattern is three candlestick pattern. By the combination or the pair of three candles, we identify the possible reversal. So in this lecture number 14, we discuss single candlestick pattern first. Before applying to single candlestick pattern, you should remember the golden rules. The first golden rule for applying the single candlestick pattern is no color matters in case of single candlestick pattern. As we already discussed, that single candle itself give you the reversal pattern. That single candlestick will not require any color confirmation. That means at the absolute bottom or absolute top, it may be a red color candle or it may be a green color candle. We also consider the volume behavior along with the candlestick pattern. If the volumes are higher, it shows a more confirmative for the reversal pattern. Shape is also matter in all candlestick patterns. Single candlestick pattern, we also consider the shape, the proportion of shadow and the body. The most important golden rule that you remember is position. We always consider absolute top and absolute bottom for considering the position. We think that absolute top and absolute bottom is best position to consider the candlestick reversal patterns. As we already know that tops and bottoms are the most indicators of greed and fear. At the bottom of the market, the traders are in great fear. In the top of the market, the buyers are in the great greed. The top and bottom is always be considered according to the time frame. So for example, if we consider daily charts, then 52 week high and the low is considered to be the absolute top and bottom. If we consider 30 days and 15 minute intraday chart, then 30 days high and 30 days low will be considered as absolute top and absolute bottom. Then next golden rule will be confirmation of trade is always be done from next candle. If we consider a single candlestick pattern as a reversal pattern, then all trades will be done from the next candle. After taking positions, keep patience for next 3 to 5 candles to perform along with candlestick patterns. So please remember, keep 3 to 5 candlestick patience after taking positions. After considering the golden rules, now we discuss the type of single candlestick pattern. In this single candlestick pattern, we first discuss reversal patterns. The first reversal pattern that we are discussing is called as hammer. Let's understand the hammer pattern in depth. As the picture shown in your screen, you'll see a candle which is a very low body and a very long shadow. There is no or negligible shadow above the real body. It is look like an all pin, which is a top and a deep tail. As you also show in this graph, which is shown on your screen, that a trend which is already downside, and at the absolute bottom the hammer is for candle is formed in the color of red. From the next candle onwards, the price is moved upward, so we easily take the positions for it. Before finalizing the hammer pattern, we consider the various key factors. Let's discuss in detail. The first and the foremost factor is the prior trend should be downtrend. The pattern should be identified at absolute bottoms. The pattern shows a final sell-off in morning and profit booking by the sellers in the later time. Color not matter in this pattern. It should be red or it can be a green. Shadow is more than two times of the real body. So it is look like an all pin, which is the shadows are more than two times. Now we discuss the next pattern called as shooting star. As the picture seen on your screen, it is an opposite of hammer pattern. The pattern is look like a inverted all pin. That means bottom top, the top all pin is at bottom and shadow will be above the real body. As we seen in the chart also, the trend is prior trend is strong and we see a pattern which clearly shows that it is a loose of control. Before finalizing the shooting star, we again consider various key factors. The first and the foremost factor is the prior trend is uptrend. The position is absolute top. The final buying in the morning and profit booking by the buyers in the later time. Color not matter in this position, whether it is red or green, it doesn't matter. Shadow is more than two times and it is above the real body. This pattern finally shows that the buyers lose the control. Now from the next candle onwards, we take a sell or a short positions and keep patience for next 3 to 5 candles. After discussing two reversal pattern of hammer and shooting star, now we discuss a single candlestick pattern which is a continuation pattern and called as doji. As is shown in on your screen, a picture which shows a cross symbol or a gravestone doji or in the formation of dragonfly doji. All three patterns have one common factor. The real body is negligible. That means opening and closing are at the same level. It also considered to be that buyers and the sellers both are not in a control. This situation is also considered to be indecision position. In the first position, the open and the close is almost the same and the upper shadow and the lower shadow are in the same proportion. It is called as doji. In the next pattern, it is considered to be the gravestone doji, where low, open and close at the same level and the shadow will be above the real body. That same body is considered to be the good support level. In the dragonfly doji, we see a high, open and close at same level and the lower shadow is considered. The shadow is created below the real body. Before considering any doji pattern, we consider the key factors. First, doji can be created or any type of doji can be created at mid of the trends. The pattern or the trend will be sideways or we consider as range bound markets, where neither the buyers control the market, neither the sellers control the market. If any pattern, doji pattern is formed in the mid of the trend, it is considered to be the continuation of the prior trend. So if we are in the uptrend and the doji is formed, then we think that the uptrend will be continued. The most common key factor is there is no real body. Opening and closing should be same. No position is required in the formation of doji. we have to just look for wait and watch condition until the prior trend is resumed. So after considering all three patterns, we just summarize the thing. In the reversal pattern, single candlestick pattern, we see a hammer at bottom, look like an all pin, and shooting star at top. And we also discuss continuation pattern in the form of doji.